Thank you guys for coming. And where is Mr. Lazaro?
Green Lazaro is not here because of family matters.
Oh, emergencies. Okay, that's fine. And we need the reports for the specific departments. Would you guys report on anything?
Yes, I have in our sales department. So, tomorrow, what? I'll draw the graph for in order for us to understand. So, I look at it as weekly report. A weekly sales from the past few months from March to May this year, 2017, is averaging 450,000 pesos, enough to reach our quota, which is 2 million. But unfortunately, this past few weeks we have observed the decrease on our sales. That we can see on our monthly sales report. So here is the monthly sales report. So let's say that this is this is March. Sorry. March, then I think it continues to increase as normal, but on the past few weeks, as I have said,
last few weeks of April, right?
Yes, it decreases by 7% to be exact. And we need to get back in the line compared to this, because we fall.
Okay.
Look at the difference, it's too high compared to this.
Yes.
So we need to be back. We need to point again an edge to our competitors.
Yes.
So any opinions, any suggestions what we should do?
We will see later. Yes, we'll do it later. Can you support this report for the budget for the finance department? Well, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Well, for the financial department, past our target of strongly balanced operating budget, but still we are continuing to improve the delivery of cost-effective services. And lastly, we actively seek to increase our budget reserves to 25% and reduce our debt by 25% in the next 5 years. So that will be all.
So for my department, the marketing department, since I have consulted with the two, the finance and the sales, and as you heard from Paolo and Ms. Moreno, that I have come to learn their company really needs innovation and development in terms of our products and services. So in line with this, I have also studied our marketing plan, and it seemed to be a bit weak, or should I say weak already, so I guess we need to think and brainstorm something that can be of help to get our company Cosi Gusto to be on track in our business.
Okay, so alright, based on the reports, we know we really need to make some improvements and adjustments. You guys prepared proposals, right? So
yes.
How about we discuss the proposals?
Sure, ma'am.
Sure, yeah. Who would like to go first? Mr. Earl, our second.
So the attached proposal represents Cosi Gusto's formal offer to provide catering services for the next event described earlier. Upon the terms and conditions and pricing provided, as planning begins, some of the details in this document will change to suit their preferences and priorities. So the projected objectives of this project is that we can deliver all of these services while staying within their design catering budget. And the key details is there will be an assortment of finest pizza and knowledgeable and experienced staff. And lastly, Quasi Custos of both a white selection of silverware. So that's pretty much it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Arcega. So next, Sir Paolo. Sir Venta. Are you ready? You ready? Okay. Would you like?
I like the idea of the catering service. It's something new for us.
It is.
So I'm here again.
Okay.
My proposal that I made is I think we should need a product launch of new pizzas and flavors for marketing event. So my general description is so that we have newly ideas, newly created flavors that soon to be added in our menu. I think a formal product launch will do to engage with our loyal customers, but also the untargeted market. So that the people that are our customers will think that they are part of our company. And I think that before releasing that new products, before adding it on the menu, we should formally introduce and expose our products to them. So my objectives and expected results of the project is, of course, we can present our ideas, our products and services, especially to the loyal customers, as I have said earlier. Second is public relations, maybe can also be matter. So the products and services are already launched formally. So I think we can create also an edge to our competitors that they don't have the kind of product launch that we have. So lastly, my key details is I'm hoping that we made it free admission, so everyone is free to join. Mm-hmm. Even
no are not
no okay. No membership. Even our not loyal customers, even those person who is interesting and curious on our restaurant. So I think it will be okay if it was held May 15th, but 17th, or held at SNX Convention Center, Pasay City. Is that okay?
Exposure.
Yes, that's what I want.
That's a good
thing. That's what I really propose. So it will be very interactive. So
yes.
The audiences will not be bored.
Yes.
So it's audiences get bored if it's just like a speaker talking and talking and talking. Mm. So I think
there will be some entertainment.
Why not?
Interactive.
At the same time, why not we invite Alfonso Rossi?
Wow, yeah.
So,
it's
good idea.
Good
idea.
Yeah.
Very, very good. Great idea.
So, Alfonso will introduce the new products because he is the man who we get our restaurant. We get our ideas.
Yes, that's
so,
right. He was our inspiration.
Is a very
good.
Yes.
Yeah. It's like a demonstration home show like that.
Wow.
As we watch in the TV.
Very good idea.
So that's my proposal. I hope you like it.
That was a great proposal, Mr.
Thank you.
So I guess Mr. Garrett Jarrett. Okay. Yes. He's very ready.
Enough.
Our special offers, discount, or limited promos type of event during the year, and this can be specific holidays such as the Labor Day, Valentine's Day, or certain time of the year such as a back to school day. This primary benefits of promotion is to attract attention to our restaurant at an opportune time and increase revenue in otherwise fine fields. And there are types of holidays. First one is recognized holiday. There's a typical holidays such as Thanksgiving, Labor Day, and second annual events. There are period of time where certain cultures events are frequently at a specific time this year. And lastly, non-traditional holiday.
Yes.
There are days of the year that parents consider being holiday but are recommended because they serve a specific purpose.
Thank you, Mr. Gavin. Very seasonal. I know my idea. Mr. Jeremy? Oh, sorry. Hey, are you mad? No, it's okay. Good morning, everyone. Morning. So, the general description of my proposal is to improve our product to maintain our customer satisfaction. Why? Because based on our evaluation results, it said that our customers are not that satisfied with our courses. So the project objectives is to strengthen the materials used in our restaurant and to meet the expectation of our loyal customers. And the key details is, I think the best way to improve our product is, number one, we can add more flavors in our specific foods, like we can make spicy, a little bit spicy tuna pizza, and that. Two, upgrade our kitchen utensils. And last, we can upgrade our interior designs. Always remember, our customers' satisfaction is very important to us. Our business is like perso. Tandaan nyo yan. Business ay hindi nag-i-stay as bata. Kailangan din niya tumanda. So, we need improvements. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Moreno. Ms. Gonzalez. So, over the years, pizza has been topped and stuffed with similar tastes, right? So now, I think it's time to get back to the basics with the ingredients that people actually want to eat. My proposal is not about changing the pizza itself or the pizza making, but about keeping it real and making pizza the way it should be, the Cosi way, or our way. So my project, or the name suggests us create your own pizza, is a pizza making from scratch. Okay. The concept will let the customers indulge in creating and customizing their own pizza by freely choosing the type of crust they want, if it's thick or thin, the choice of pizza sauce, and as well as the toppings according to their own preference. So the project objectives of my proposal is, as Cosi Gustavo expands in the pizzeria industry in a broader sense and is engaged towards creating the best for our brand, my proposal aims to provide the customers the three B's. That would be. The three B's. So that would be better food, better vibe, and better experience. Being sensitive to the needs and wants of our customers, we also look to provide great value with its goal of letting the customers be the boss in creating their own kind of pizza. My proposal will not just help our company produce more profit, but as well as a way in establishing a much more value-satisfied product. My proposal also allows its customers that they can be their own chef, use their imagination, and come up with the best master pizza. So the key detail would be, besides indulging in a unique culinary experience, the concept features a one set price for 300 pesos. So I have here also my proposed brochure or flyers here. It's a 3-page brochure and as well as the posters. So that will be all. Thank you.
Right, because it's my turn.
I'm gonna ask you guys a question. How long have we been established as a company?
10 years.
Mm-hmm. 10 years.
Mm-hmm. 10 years
already. Yeah, it's been 10 years. So my proposal is not about market penetration. It's about customer retention. One way of doing that is sponsorships. The general description of my proposal is
we no longer need market penetration, just like what I said earlier. And sponsorships is a way to strengthen our relationships with other companies and also the customers we've been with before. For our project objectives, this event sponsorships is for our customers to retain moments with our company and exposure for possible customers. This is also a good strategy to gain good company relationships with other companies, which could lead to referrals, which we love because we love customer loyalty.
Yes.
We expect good results from the strategy, such as increase in brand awareness and customers and referrals. For our key details, there will be booths near the event. The sponsorships we aim to get are for seminars, the ones that are held in hotels, and outside the function hall, there could be booths. And they're just small booths, and we could have a TV screen there that could play our 5-minute video that informs our customers about how we started our commercials.
Do you have a visual bit of it?
The commercial?
Or the business app?
Yes, I made one. And I made one poster. You guys can probably see. This is a poster, and this is what it could possibly look like.
Okay.
We could have this almost this high, this big tarpaulin with the poster Miss Gonzalez made because I really like her proposal. And there could be a booth right there. Can you guys see? There could be a booth, and there are some there are some tables and chairs inside, which we could serve our customers. We could offer ready-made food, boxes of pizza. We could offer takeout or even dine-in, so we could share the experience with them. And for inquiries, of course, the main purpose of this proposal is the inquiries and the customers. We have a team to assist them and answer their questions. So that is all. That is my proposal.
Okay.
How about we have a 10-minute, hopefully 10 minutes, deliberation
about the proposal.
Mine is for the catering services. And Event with Alfonso.
Can you vote
for
two?
Can I vote for two?
Yeah, we can do two events, right?
Okay.
Yes. That's okay. Another one for me, Event with Alfonso.
Okay.
How about you guys?
I will vote for Event with Alfonso and Catering.
Catering.
They vote for Catering.
Mr. Valenzona?
I vote for creator owning improving products.
How about you, Mr. Garil?
I vote improving products.
Sorry. Ms. Gonzalez?
I have voted already. It's your
time. Oh, yeah.
So
it's
my.
I like the event. I like the
like a 3-in-1 proposal. Mm.
That would be merge two proposals with
the event and the create your own for its launch, and then launch another line like the catering service. Mm.
So we will do two events.
That do you guys agree?
Yes. But I'm gonna be honest, this will hurt our budget.
Yes.
This will be really expensive, but if you guys think this will work, then let's go. Let's do all three of them.
I think it's worth the risk.
Yeah, it is. So, alright, are we good? We have decided.
Yes.
I think Miss Moran has announcements.
Oh, I forgot.
So good.
Okay.
We will be having an announcement. So, on May 8th, we will have our next meeting. Anytime, 8 o'clock sharp, same place, discussion room. And the subject of the next meeting will be about the proposal for the No Borders topic. That's all.
Okay. Right. Thank you, Ms. Moreno. Everyone, thank you for coming. Meeting is now adjourned.
Thank you.
Thank you.